This tutorial shows you how to calculate the minimum required sample size for the paired Wilcoxon test, also referred to as the Wilcoxon signed rank test, with GPower. When we start GPower, we get this overview by default. We now need to select the paired Wilcoxon test first. This can be done via tests, means, two dependent groups, matched pairs, Wilcoxon non-parametric. Now you have to select the type of power analysis. Since you have to calculate the minimum required sample size in advance, you have to select a priori. The first input parameter you have to specify is whether you are conducting a one-tailed or two-tailed paired Wilcoxon test. Two-tailed means you cannot tell in advance which of the two measurements is larger. If you do, however, select one-tailed. The second input parameter is the assumed parent distribution. Min ARE, or asymptotic relative efficiency, is the most conservative assumption and usually a good default. The third input parameter needed is the effect size Cohen's DZ. The conventions according to the GPower manual are the same as for the t-test, 0.2, 0.5 and 0.8 for small, medium and large effect sizes. If you have research field specific thresholds, use those instead. However, if you have a preliminary study or comparative study where an effect size already exists, then you should rather use that. Usually those studies report the effect size R for the Wilcoxon test. A transformation aforehand is necessary though, using the formula provided by Cohen, 1988, on page 23. The fourth input parameter is the alpha error probability, which is the probability of committing a type 1 error. In short, this is the probability of wrongly rejecting the null hypothesis. 5% is the typical convention, 1% is a bit more restrictive. A value above 5% should be avoided though. The fifth input parameter is power. Power equals 1 minus the beta error probability. Beta error is the type 2 error. In short, this means falsely retaining the null hypothesis. 95% power is typical, meaning you have a 5% type 2 error probability. In some research fields, 0.8 is used here. This means you automatically accept a type 2 error of up to 20%. If you have power lower than 0.95, this usually calls for a reasonable justification. Finally, hit calculate to see the minimum number of observations needed to detect the presumed statistical effect for the paired Wilcoxon test with the predefined type 1 error probability and power. As a rule of thumb, a smaller effect size and a larger power require more observations than the other way around.